My topic is about open source handwriting recognition. So what I am talking about is a possibility of an input method that can recognize handwriting and also which is an open source software. So everyone will be thinking like, Google keyboard is there, it works fine, and you can write your language like Malayalam, Hindi, English, whatever. So what's wrong with that? So we can use that, right? So yeah, we as free software enthusiasts, we don't have to actually enlightened about how non-free software will affect us. One most important reason is privacy. Keyboard is like one of the most important app where like we type everything using that keyboard app. So whatever might be our usernames, passwords, our search histories, all everything. So like that data, like Google actually, yeah, we all know that Google thrives on our data. So the should we actually give away that control to Google or any other thing? Can we do an open source version that works just as fine? That's what we are looking at. Yeah, so before that, like this is actually developed primarily by Sandosh Thottingal, and I am just a contributor. So actually how it works is, like all the handwriting recognition thing, actually that doesn't require like complex machine learning to actually work. There are algorithms that can actually does curve matching. So if you write a character or something, we can actually match with a predefined curve that we stored inside. Like for example, a curve, let's say C. If we store C, and we can actually, whatever, when user writes C, and we can match with the stored character C and check whether that matches. That's the much simple version. So thing with the handwriting recognition is users don't always write the same way. And even I write like one time this, like it is not the same. So we have to actually make sure that it will work in most of the cases, like for example, if it is written slightly bigger, slightly smaller, in a like a slightly tilted way, especially on the mobile writing, we usually write slightly tilted way, and it should actually handle distortions. We don't write that perfectly, and it should tolerate some sort of errors. So what we use is there is a algorithm called procustes analysis. I'm not spelling it right, I think. Yeah. So what it does is actually this is one curve, and we are trying to match whether these curves are similar. So you can see that this actually is a distorted way of this. So what it does is it will actually scale about to the same size, then it will actually shift that to the same position. The position is different over here. It will shift to that position, and then just rotate with the orientation. And then we will compare that curve and find out like whether the details are matched, like cursive state. It doesn't need to be exactly the same, but it will actually match those things. That is the core thing. That is the only thing that actually we have to do. I will show a demo later, like how that things works. So yeah, we actually solved that, right? We write like this. If there is one thing stored, we can match against that, done. So apparently things are not that much simple. So there are like similar characters. For example, if you write zero, I'm actually taking the example for Malayalam, but it works almost, there is a case for almost same in almost every Indian languages. So we are focusing on Indian languages here. So actually there are like lot of similar characters in here. Like for zero, the Malayalam letter ta and Malayalam consonant that end anaswaram. So this thing actually is written similarly. We cannot actually match whether it is a zero or O or this thing. So yeah, this is actually a problem. There are like other similar characters like colon and this thing. So users like don't exactly write as same as that. And for the similar characters like maybe English O and zero, these things we cannot actually match that easily. And there are variants like we have to use. For example, some people use write to like this. Some people actually put a loop over here. Some people actually put some curve in here. So as far as some Malayalam characters also concerned, some people actually put the this thing in here. There are some variants in that. So that's also a challenge for that. And there is composite characters. Composite characters means, this is available in almost all languages. It is this character that is called inta, that is composed of two characters, na and ta. So, yeah, we have to actually, no one writes na hyphen ta, ta, and people usually write in composite way. And especially like a composite character can be like three or four characters combined. For example, it is like Sri or other characters. Like for example, Sri, it can be like written as like a single character itself. And there is overlapping ligages also. Like for example, my name itself, A, Na, E. So actually the Na and this comes in the actually the same space. It actually overlaps in this, and this also actually gets together. The same case, how we write Andy and things like that. So it actually, there are characters that are actually combined. So it is actually not feasible to actually match store every combinations in this thing. There is there is one thing that we can use, like for all characters mapping, like combining like all coordinates and things like that, it is like really complex. So we actually is developing a training UI that also I will show. Yeah, so there is something that we can do for the things that I have mentioned earlier. One is similar characters. For example, I'm writing this thing, like 101, okay. So I'm writing like just a pure number. So as a we can actually use the context there so that we can say if I write a phone number, we even know that it is not the English letter O, it is not the Malayalam that, it should be zero. Yeah, and also like we can use the grammar rules to actually resolve that thing. For example, this thing is much more complex because the same shape will actually is coming here and here. But we can actually refer to the dictionary of that thing, so that dictionary and the grammar rules, so that we can actually resolve those ambiguities. And we can use the auto completion. For example, if we use like that is in Malayalam of Chief Minister, that is Mukhya Mandri. So that is Mukhya Ma. If you write till like that, we can actually say with a certain percentage of certainty that the Indri, that thing will be the next. So with that type of prediction, we can actually do that. So there is like word prediction also. Like in SMC, we actually developed that word prediction for Malayalam. So we can actually write a starting character and see that what will be the next probable word. So if we write a two word, and if some of the things we cannot actually understand, like software cannot understand, but we can actually use that word prediction to predict like much more accurate, which is that. So that kind of disambiguation things can be done, and we need actually auto completion also, so that we don't have to, we usually don't write like all the way, like first few characters we will know that what will be the next, and then we can actually do that. So yeah, I will show a basic demo. Yeah, I'm going to type a Malayalam word into that. That is my name. Yeah. So
I can confirm.
Yeah, so the there are actually, oh, sorry. Yeah, so you can see like there are some struggles that we are trying to resolve. Yeah, so this actually works with other modules also. Like for example, the language Tamil. So I don't know the language. So it actually recognizes that. So what we actually need is, sorry. Yeah, so this is actually, I will show a demo of a training UI also. Just give me a second. Yeah, this is like, we will show all, like store all the shapes like two and the next two, we will like that. And this is one store shape, we want to add an another variant, we can actually add like this. Yeah, so this is one, yeah, so what we need is actually, you actually asked whether, how can we verify, like, this is not my language. Yeah, we need actually more language experts to actually add more languages to it. Each language is unique and actually requires, although the framework is same, we need actually, in the post-processing work, each language is different. So Malayalam, we actually have like much more resources, thanks to Sundar Malayalam Computing. So we need actually more language experts. For example, Tamil, I don't know, so I cannot actually develop rules for that, for easily Kannada, Hindi, and other things. And more usage, I know it is not going to happen right now because it is not ready yet. So Malayalam, actually, we added like most basic set of characters, so it is available. And we need actually full set for Tamil and other languages. And for the post-processing also, we need actually, this is actually developed in JavaScript. Actually, Jishnu over there actually ported this to Android. So we actually need much more developers to actually continue with this. And yeah, we need, after a basic set is complete, we need more usage so that you can also submit feedback. So this is the website you can actually go and check. This entire code is available, and there you can see the demo in that / handwriting. Yeah. So I'm really indebted to Santosh Thottingal and Deepthi to for my help in presentation. Thank you.
Any questions?
This is not a question, this is just a comment. I know about, I came to know about SMC around 7 years back. At the time, like, I think the tagline is same. So my computer, my language, it was pretty fascinating. The projects which is being done at SMC is pretty good, and kudos to that. I just wanted to say, you know, I've been reading Santosh's blogs for a long time, and like, I must say, I being a Keralite, knowing Malayalam, this guy has taught me more than what my Malayalam teachers has taught me in like 10 years. So he has, you know, he has got some award from President for contributions to Malayalam language. I think as a community here, we are from different states. We should adopt this. The same thing which SMC has been following for a long time, and we have a long list of languages, and we should develop our own language. Thanks.
Yeah, so that's also one of the things we are struggling. Like, most of us are Malayali, so for adopting it other languages, there are some efforts, but yeah, we need actually more to handle. So there are actually issues that are open in there. You can actually open issues. Pull requests are always welcome. So I actually review those regularly. So yeah, we need more contribution.
So my question is, the initial set of curves when you generate, like, do you crowdsource the, like, a lot of different handwriting samples and then average it out, or do you go with like team input, like your own initial handwriting sets?
Yeah, this thing is like, for the letter R, I only actually stored only one curve. So thing is, like, an advantage of this method is we don't have to actually get lot of training data.
Okay.
So just one curve per character per style is really
so
okay.
This is a static curve decided by someone who knows the language, that this is the average.
Yeah, this
shape
is the curve.
Once.
Like, we will write like this.
Not generated that, yeah. From user input.
Yeah, it is not generated.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So thing is, once it is completed, we can actually do something like what, like, the Indie keyboard does is it doesn't send any data out of the mobile.
Okay.
So we can actually get that process also, so that we know that our privacy is guaranteed.
Cool. Thanks.